Hey everyone, today we're doing another species spotlight, and that is on this amazing little girl, the Honduran milk snake. These girls are, girls and boys, are some of the largest milk snake species that there are. So milks and king snakes all technically belong to kind of the same genus, which is Lampropeltis, and that's the kings of milks, which are North American colubrid snakes that are usually diurnal or crepuscular. And most of them actually don't get very large, like most of them rarely exceed 4 feet. But there are a couple species out there, and these included, that just turn into absolute monsters. These ones are arguably the largest milk snake species. The black milk snake does attain a pretty large size, and hopefully one day we'll get one of those amazing little dream snakes. But Honduran milk snakes, average 4 to 5 feet, which is about 1.5 feet longer than most average snakes that you think of, like California king snakes and desert king snakes and even gray bands and stuff like that. But there have been recorded animals over the 6 and even 7 foot range for just like a monster girl. So Iota here, who following my first snakes when I first got into them following the Roman numerals, is a tangerine albino Honduran milk snake. So what that means is that naturally occurring, there is a form of basically hypomelanistic called tangerine. Hypomelanistic, again, is the reduction of pattern. And then the albino is the visually recessive, which lacks all melanin. There's still other colors in there, which is why it's not pure white. So like azanophores and anerythrophores and stuff like that. But we have another one. His name is Ada, who is a white phase, who's not as big. He's a little bit more flighty. But he's downstairs, so we like Iota because she's a very calm, big girl. Honduran milk snakes are amazing animals. So obviously they come from Honduras, where they get their name from. They're also found in Nicaragua, as well as like the highest point, like the furthest north you can go and still be in Costa Rica. These guys, so thinking about where that is, Central America, they're a little bit more tropical. So when we think about husbandry and stuff like that, is that, you know, they need a little bit more kind of consistent warmth. So for instance, there, because it is the tropics, there isn't as much variation of summer to winter as there is in like the rest of North America. So like the United States, it's like a corn snake, the temps vary a little bit more. Their winters dip down into like the 50s and stuff. In Honduras, Nicaragua, and stuff like that, it's more like the mid to high 60s. So they will still kind of brumate a little bit, but not nearly as long and nearly as like I don't want to say traumatic event, but more like of a big thing as it does for a lot of like the other corns, milks, and kings that we have further north in mainland North America. So the other thing is that they do come from a little bit more of a humid climate. So that doesn't necessarily mean you have to keep them like a ball python or a boa constrictor, but like ambient normal humidity that we have in most houses and stuff here in the United States is probably fine for these guys, but maybe throw a little bit of sphagnum moss or give them a big, big water dish for them to fully soak in just in case for humidity and such. But these guys are awesome. Supposedly they do pretty well in smaller, you know, containers. So if you're keeping them in a rack system or an enclosure or something like that, a little bit smaller, like, so for an adult, like if you're keeping it in like an enclosure, like a, you know, 24 inch or 40 gallon aquarium is probably all you need for something like this. I know people who keep small adult males in 32 quart tubs, but honestly, I think that's a little small, but that's just kind of my preference. So I've been moving all of my colubrids into larger, tub enclosures or just regular enclosures if they're not kept in a wrap system here. So for instance, all of my milks and corns, with the exception of like the baby gray band and the ones that are kept kind of more in a little bit more arid climates, I'm now moving into 41 quarts for the smaller like variable king snake. And then for the corns, kings, and my Hondurans here, they're moving to the 71 quarts or like the giant like under bed mattress, like comforter boxes and stuff like that. These guys are absolutely amazing. Them being milk snakes and kings, being part of the same family, means that they will more than likely eat each other. So housing them together isn't necessarily the best idea in the world, but that's not like you can't breed them either. You just kind of need to keep an eye on them if that's what you're planning on doing and breeding them or anything like that. These guys are just amazing, amazing little animals. As I said kind of in the past with a few other videos, I started off as more of like a boa python kind of a guy, but colubrids are just such amazing animals. And as we also said before, that colubrid is such an all-inclusive, encompassing, giant kind of nondescript group of reptiles that there's so much variation of just the different genre of them. And then even in the individual species and stuff, there's so much variation. Like, this is a giant, giant monster of a milk snake. Like, I don't know exactly know how long she is, but she's got to be at least 4.5 feet long. Yeah, probably about 4.5 feet long. But they're just so amazing. And then you have my tiny little baby gray band, or, you know, the Brooks Kings and the Florida Kings. Those get really big too. But just a little quick little species spotlight about some amazing little ones of these. I would absolutely recommend these for a beginner. They are a little bit harder to find. They're not as super expensive unless you're getting into like hypoalbino anerythoristic, so like a snow or something like that, and you're getting like pounding on genes, because there are a couple different genes that have been proven out, like anery and stuff like that. But they're pretty non-expensive, a little bit harder to find, but they are a little bit bigger than just like a California king snake or something like that. I will say they don't have as big of a prey response like when I open the tub than I do with like my California king snake or the Brooks, but that doesn't mean that they're not trash cans. Like, I don't think this girl's ever refused a meal or Ada either, even when he kind of brumated himself. But hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any questions about Honduran milk snakes or really any snake, I'll do my best to answer them with the best of my knowledge. And if not, turn you guys on to somebody who I know for a fact will give you the information that you need. Please like and subscribe if you can. I hope you're having a great day, and I'll check you next time.